Hi, boys and girls, and welcome to 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Tonight, we're in for a real treat. I want to read to you Zombies Don't Eat Veggies, created by Megan and Jorge Lacerra. And I have to thank my friends Noelle and Baby George all the way down in Maryland for recommending this book because I never even heard of it. I didn't own it. It wasn't on our library shelves. So, thank you. I loved it so much. I just placed the order today, and hopefully we'll have our own copy very soon. But this is a great book. It's a funny book, and I hope you all enjoy it. Mo was a zombie with a deep, dark craving. It was dreadful, devious, absolutely despicable. Mo loved to eat vegetables. He grew all kinds of veggies in his hidden garden. And then in his secret kitchen, he crafted celery, tomatoes, and carrots into delicioso meals that he devoured with delight. I wonder, friends at home, how many of you can relate to Mo. Do you just love your veggies too? I know I do. Do you have a favorite vegetable? That would be a hard one for me. I do love carrots, but I love asparagus too. Mo seems to love them all. Mo's mom and dad did not love vegetables, not one bit. Veggies were yucky, disgusting, chaosco. They were not allowed at the Romero's dinner table. And here's Mo's dad, ready to chase some humans in the marathon next week, mijo. And his mother is saying, finger foods, mi amor. And Mo is saying, gracias, pero I'm not hungry. Zombies were supposed to eat zombie cuisines like brain cakes, brain stew, and brain and bean tortillas. Most parents insisted that their niño only eat zombie food. I don't know about you boys and girls, but veggies sound much more delicious than brain stew or brain and bean tortillas. Yuck. Mo tried to convince his mom and dad to give peas a chance. He sneaked in vegetables wherever he could. But Mo's attempts were fruitless. His parents wanted him to accept who he was, a zombie. And zombies don't eat veggies. Mo knew he did not like zombie cuisine, and he couldn't imagine letting go of spinach or cucumbers or kale forever. If zombies are only supposed to eat zombie cuisine, Mo started to wonder if maybe he wasn't a zombie after all. Day after day, Mo wondered how he could make his parents understand his love of veggies. His tomatoes were tantalizing, his cucumbers crispy, the peppers perfection. Add onions, some garlic, a touch of cilantro, and gazpacho! Holy aioli, Mo had an idea. His best one yet. Do you know what gazpacho is, my friends? Gazpacho is a cold soup with tomatoes and lots of other veggies as its base. That's what makes up the entire soup, actually. And it's quite delicious. Do you think Mo's parents will like it, though? Let's find out. Mo grabbed his book of recipes. His fingers flew across the pages until he found it. The recipe for a tomato and veggie-filled soup. He was sure the tomatoes would make it look bloody and goopy, just like a zombie dish. His parents were going to devour it. Mo chopped and diced, blended and pureed, perfected and poured. Finally, the soup was finished. Mo carefully shuffled it over to the house for dinner. Oh yeah, because over here is his secret kitchen, right? That's where he cooks all the veggies up. Now he's going to bring it to home, and I think he's going to try to trick Mom and Dad into telling them that it's a zombie dish when really it's a healthy veggie dish. Will they fall for it? Where he found a feast fit for a zombie. And Dad says, Mo, you're just in time. And Mom says, try some empanadas, mi amor. Prime cuts. Mira, I made spicy mayonnaise. And you can see, boys and girls, there's pickled tongue, arroz con spleens, famoso chili con ojo, and ojos are your eyes, Doritos for dipping, and empanadas instead of empanadas. Get it? Ah. Doesn't look like they're ready for Moe's gazpacho, does it? I made something for you to try, too. It's called Blood Bile Bisque. Bon Appetit gave it 5 brains.
Smells strange. Looks delightful.
5 brains? Must be delicioso. And so they dug in. Moe closed his eyes and sucked his breath. This was it. They'd savor the soup. They'd ask for mas. Moe imagined breakfasts, lunches, dinners, snacks, all vegetables, raw, cooked, steamed, and fried, forever and ever. He saw all his dreams coming true. Until Moe's parents did not like the soup. Not one bit. Dios mijo, this soup tastes like vegetables. Yuck! Moe's heart sank to his toes. His plan was a bust.
How many times do we have to tell you that zombies don't eat veggies?
Maybe other zombies don't eat vegetables, but I do, Mom and Dad. I'm different. But I'm still me, Mauricio Romero, your niño, your Moe. Moe reminded his parents that he liked chasing humans as they ran in marathons, and he promised he'd always cheer for Dad during championship brain-eating competitions. He also loved doing the zombie shuffle under the moonlight with Mom. He was a zombie, a Romero. He just liked to eat vegetables. Moe's parents loved their son and finally accepted that it was okay to be different. They even promised Moe that they would eat more veggies for him, but only a teeny tiny bit. And so here we have fried fiddlehead ferns, artichoke hearts and elbow macaroni, pata cones, ears of corn with Dead Sea salt and butter, be still my hearts of palm chopped salad. The Romeros knew that most zombies don't eat veggies, but they were more than zombies. They were a family. Mercado de la Familia Romero, the Romeros family market. And over here, boys and girls, I love when books have recipes in the back. There's a recipe for Moe's garden gazpacho that you could try at home, should you check this book out at your local public library. There's also a recipe for zombie finger foods. How fun. And the Romero family's famous shock-a-mole instead of guacamole. What a treat. I hope you enjoyed that story. Thanks again to my friends, Noel and Baby George down there in Maryland. I so appreciate you recommending this book. All right, we're going to go ahead and sing our lullabies now. We're going to sing Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, followed by God Bless the Moon. Sing with me at home. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Good, and now our moon song. I see the moon and the moon sees me. God bless the moon and God bless me. And God bless you, boys and girls at home. As always, thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you again real soon on 5 Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Good night.